A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Wassalatu wassalamu ala sayyidina wa nabiyyina wa tabib nufusina wa habib qulubina abil qasim Muhammad. صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم لا سيما بقية الله روحي وأرواح العالمين لتراب مقدمه الفداء. Respected brothers and sisters in Islam, السلام عليكم جميعا ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. دعاء كوميل almost consists of 1500 words. Heavenly words that uncovers about three pages of A4 size papers with the normal font. All right. When I go through the Kumayl, I can categorically divide the Kumayl that is focusing on four main subjects. Four main topics are covering the whole Kumayl. One subject or one aspect of the Kumayl is Imam Ali alayhi salam is giving us brilliant descriptions of the Almighty God. He is beseeching and seeking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's help through his divine names and attributes, beautiful names and attributes as we go through. So one facet of the Kumayl is throughout the Kumayl, Imam is talking about divine names and attributes, introducing to us the real concept of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, giving us insight about God. The opposite side of it, on the other hand, the second subject and topic of the Kumayl is that Imam Ali alayhi salam is introducing himself as a da'i, as a supplicant to the Almighty God, who I am. As I will go just quickly through it, you will see that over 30 descriptions Imam Ali alayhi salam is giving to himself, representing as a human being in the presence of God, as a makhluq, as a creation of God, in the presence of God, introducing God with all the sublime attributes and introducing himself with absolute poverty and humility, as you can see. The third topic and subject that, subhanallah, is just, I can imagine, remember tasbih and the threads of going through all the beans, every single word of the Kumayl. Imagine a bin of tasbih and a thread that is going through all of it. That thread is the third topic of the Kumayl, and that is Imam Ali alayhi salam from the very beginning. Allahumma inni as'aluka, all the way to the end of the Kumayl, waf'al bima anta ahlu. Throughout the Kumayl, Imam is in the presence of God. And this is the most fascinating part of the Kumayl to me, that from the beginning of this dua to the end of it, Imam Ali is in the presence of God. And the way that he's conversing God, see how sometimes we can say that La ilaha illa hu, he, God is so and so. Sometimes you are talking face to face, addressing each other. From beginning to the end of the Kumayl, Imam Ali is in the presence of God and is addressing the Almighty God, and therefore he is using the pronouns always you, 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 from the beginning to the end of it. And the fourth, Imam Ali alayhi salam, in the fourth topic that you can see throughout the Kumayl, is teaching us, in fact, or is we are learning from Imam Ali how to ask and what to ask. And especially to the level of Amir al-Mu'mineen. From beginning of the Kumayl, nowhere throughout these three pages of A4 size, as I said, the Kumayl, you will never see a word of one single request for dunya. That Imam Ali alayhi salam is asking, for example, Ya Rab, financially I'm low, marital issues I have, I don't know, health issues and anything, things that usually first comes to our mind. Never throughout the Kumayl Imam Ali is asking, touching on any of such issues. In fact, never Imam Ali is asking for the bliss in paradise either. Like you never seen throughout the Kumayl Imam Ali alayhi salam saying, Wazawijni min al hur al ain, for example, Ya Allah, associate me to hur al ain, I want rivers of honey, milk, and all the bliss of paradise, with all respect to them, and all the blessings of God. You see, Imam Ali alayhi salam is wailing on the one hand, is crying on the one hand from the hellfire. And what he says is more severe to him than the flame of the hellfire is dissociation from God. And therefore, as we go through it, Imam Ali alayhi salam says, I might be able, hypothetically speaking, tolerate the hellfire, your hellfire. Remember, always Imam is in direct communication with God. I might, hypothetically speaking, be able to tolerate your hellfire, but I cannot even imagine. And therefore, Ali has no patience whatsoever when it comes to dissociation from the Almighty God. Inshallah, when we get to that part, I will explain and elaborate more on it. On the other hand, you see, Imam Ali is yearning for association with God, yearning for meeting with God and being with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as he will say, وَأَجْتَمِعَ فِي جَوَارِكَ مَعَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, towards the end of it. So, on the one hand, Imam is wailing and crying, lest I will be hellbound. And the meaning of hell to Imam Ali, the highest meaning of hell, is the hell of dissociation. And he's yearning for paradise, but the paradise Imam Ali is yearning for is the paradise of what we call it Jannatul Liqa, association and meeting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These are the four main topics that cover the whole Dua Kumayl. Now, we look into them, inshallah, very briefly. I really endeavor to be as brief as I can. I hope I can finish it, inshallah, in one go tonight. First, remember that Imam Ali alayhi salam, Dua Kumayl begins with 10 divine characteristics, divine beautiful characteristics to which Imam Ali beseeches and is asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because of them. Allahumma inni as'aluka birahmatika allati wasa'at kulla shay. The mercy of God, that His mercy, the Imam says that your mercy is encompassing everything. Please look for this word, kulla shay, everything, that goes through all these 10 divine characteristics. That's why we refer to the divine attributes as being infinite, unlimited, boundless, however you want to describe it. The mercy of God is so inclusive, sabaqat rahmatuhu ghadaba, is so inclusive that it covers even the anger and the wrath of God as well. Then the Imam says that, I beseech you by your might and power that again is infinite. Your jabarut, compensation, if as one of the meanings, that is comprehensive and covering. I beseech you by your sultana and your kingdom, again encompasses everything. Nothing goes out of your control. Nothing goes out of your kingdom. Nothing goes out of your might and omnipotence. Nothing goes out of your knowledge. وَبِعِلْمِكَ الَّذِي أَحَاطَ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ. Your knowledge that is encompassing, engulfing everything. 10 divine characteristics. Your nur that is covering and everything. Then the Imam says that, now that was your descriptions. Now let me tell you who I am and how I am. From here, as I said, over 30 descriptions Imam gives to himself, subhanAllah. Absolute humiliation before God. Cannot be further than this. Imam says that, I am so desperate. أَفْرَطَ بِسُوءُ حَالِي. I'm desperate. I have come to you empty-handed. I have nothing to offer. أَصُرَتْ بِأَعْمَالِي. I have no good action to say that Ali is here because of this, and I deserve because of that. Imam says that, I'm also sitting here. قَعَدَتْ بِأَغْلَالِي. I'm chained by like the chains of dunya. خَدَعَتْنِ الدُّنْيَا بِغُرُورِهَا. Dunya has deceived me with all its allurements and things that have been alluring me from in dunya. Again, Imam says that I'm imprisoned in my whims and desire. I have deceived myself by just postponing, saying that come tomorrow, inshallah from tomorrow. Bear with me, Tom, inshallah, will explain how can these things be said from Imam Ali alayhi salam. Does he really mean it for himself? There's a very controversial issue, and inshallah, we will have a good presentation for that. But so far, as I said, we are just surfing in the ocean of the Dua Kumayl. Anyway, Imam says that I'm khadi, physically, my appearance, my outer side, I'm so humble before you. Mutazallil, I'm drowned in humiliation. خاشعون, internally I'm also so humble. اشتدت فاقته, you know who has come to you, Ya Rab? The one who, like, the poverty has gone to the extreme, to the crunch, has touched the crunch, like.
أنزل بك حاجته. I have brought my need only to you. I have nowhere else and nowhere else to go. If you say no to me, I'm dead, I'm finished, because there's no one else out there to help me. Subhanallah, we get a goosebump even when we serve on the Akamil. Imam says that, but on the other hand, I'm so much filled with hope when I consider your karam. عَظُمَ فِي مَا عِنْدَكَ رَغْبَتُ. My hope is so great because when I look at you. And then another description says, and I am mu'tazir, I am seeking your forgiveness. نَادِم, regretful, مُنْكَسِر, I'm broken. I'm completely broken. مُسْتَغِيل, seeking forgiveness. مُسْتَغْفِر, seeking your pardon. Different words. مُنِيب, God, I'm here because I've decided to make a U-turn in my life. مقر, I am a confessor here with no justification whatsoever. مذعنون, معترفون, I'm admitter, I'm apologetic sitting here. And يا رب, لا أجد مفرًا. As I said, there is no exit for me anymore. That's how a supplicant is supposed to feel. That's the environment a supplicant is supposed to make for himself. Imam says, a slave is here, not a master, not an arrogant person, a slave. And hence, during the Akumal, we sit on the floor, not on the chair, as an expression of humbleness. Unless those who really physically are unable, that's a different story. Dhalil, humiliated, haqir, so low, miskin, poor, mustakin, like someone who is paralyzed, disabled completely. Yet, God, I have only one capital. I have nothing to bring here other than one thing, and that is my hope in you. And, Ya Rab, I have only one weapon to use here, and that is my tears, nothing else. Subhanallah. Do you see how Imam Ali alayhi salam is describing himself before the Almighty God? The more humiliation before God, the more the Almighty God elevate your status. If Imam Ali alayhi salam's status is so highly elevated in the eyes of creation of God and in the eyes of God, because he's so humiliated sincerely himself before the Almighty God. Then the Imam says that was me, and again goes back, now let me tell you who I am at, the mad'ub, who I am calling upon. You are my Elah, Elahi, wa Sayyidi, wa Mawla. You are my master. You are my owner, Malik Raqi. Biyadihi nasiyati, Ya Rab. You hold my existence is all in your hand. You are all knower, or you are the all aware of my poverty. Khabiran bi faqri wa faqati. You fully know how desperate and how poor I am. And you are my Rab, Rabbe, yani Rabbi, my Lord, my cherisher. God, I know you will be so pleased, so easily pleased. It's just enough to approach you and you forgive. فَعَالٌ لِمَا تَشَى. God, I know that you do as you will. And that's why, God, you are the medicine of all diseases. You are the healer of all hearts. سابق النعم, you are the pourer of all the blessing. You are the remover, ودافع النقم, you are the remover of any distress. I'm at the right place. I'm speaking to the right person, to the right being. نور المستحشين في الظلام, anyone, everyone, wherever we are lost, you are the nur of guidance. Then Imam Ali alayhi salam says, let me tell you who only in the hereafter will be punished. Make sure that if you are among these people, impossible, any touchment of fire comes to you. Number one, Imam says that if you are one of the muwahideen, monotheist, أَتُرَاكَ مُعَذَّبِي بِنَارِكَ بَعْدَ تُوحِيدِكَ, he's telling us, if you are a muwahid, if you die a muwahid, no hellfire will come to you. If you are one of those that, like, your heart is filled with the love of God, ضَمِيرِي مَنْ حُبِّكَ, I'm filled with the love of God. If you are one of those who sincerely in dunya confessed for his sins or her sins. If you are among the sajideen, kharrat la'azamatika sajida. Remember I told you, according to some narrations, Amirul Mu'mini from beginning to the end of the Akumal was in the position of sijda. A man came to the Prophet and says, Ya Rasulallah, would you intercede thus in the hereafter? The Prophet says, yes, but help me with long prostration. Do prostration and sujood as much as you can. By the way, Imam says that if you are among those who frequent to the houses of God, like إلى أوطان تعبدك طائعة, again you will be safeguarded from the hellfire. If you are among those that you keep asking God's forgiveness and freedom from the hellfire, no way that you will be among the hellfire. And then Imam says, let me tell you the last word. Finally, had it not been any arrogant and denier existing, any jahid or mu'anid, there would not have been any hellfire. Hellfire would have been bardan wa salama, cool and harmless and peaceful, as it became to for Prophet Ibrahim in dunya. So Imam says, make sure you are not one of the jahideen, deniers. Make sure you are not one of the arrogant people in dunya. Then you have nothing to do, inshallah, with the hellfire. Imam is crying throughout dua Kumayl. And how he's crying? Imam is crying, he himself is describing himself, subhanAllah. He is talking to God and at the same time is narrating the scene to us as well. He says, look, I'm crying like the one who has lost a very dear that cannot control their tears. He says, I'm crying like someone who's yearning in meeting with the most beloved one, cannot control their tears. And I am crying, wailing, like someone in the middle of the ocean, in the darkness of the night, that is drowning and is crying for help, desperately. That's how Amirul Mu'minin is reading Dua Kumayl from beginning to the end. Then after all of this, now Imam brings his needs. He brings his needs in three stages. I don't have time to go through all of it. I just quickly touch on it. In the first stage, that is the second part of the Dua Kumayl, Imam Ali alayhi salam says, the cause of all the calamity and the distress that we go through are going back to our sins, variety of sins. And therefore he's asking God, God, forgive sins that are like tahbisu dua, that are like obstacle between me and granting of my dua. Forgive sins that they bring calamities to me. Forgive sins that I will be out of your protection because of certain sins that I've committed. You are not protecting me. These are the causes of my problems. And therefore, first Imam goes to that as the first request. Second stage of the request, Imam says, Ya Rab, I'm sitting here. I have no respect before you, but don't disgrace me before your beings. Not only before humans. As I said, I'll tell you, Imam says that even before your angels, don't disgrace me. God, don't hasten to punish me. Give me a respite opportunity to have time to repent from the sins that I've committed. God, I'm sitting here because I'm in need, in desperate need of your mercy. I'm desperate. I'm poor and desperate. Have mercy on me. And then, these are the second stage. In the third stage, finally, Imam brings his needs. That's the part that says, "Antahaba li fi hadhihi al-layla wa fi hadhihi as-sa'a." Ya Rab, from tonight and from this time, let's open a new page. Let's have a new start. Ya Rab, from tonight, first and foremost, I ask you, I want to step to the next minute from now with no sins on my shoulder anymore. First and foremost, God, forgive all my sins. Imam subhanAllah, I'm explaining this, having goosebumps really. Imam says that forgive my sins, whether I have done it publicly or privately, apparent or hidden. Even you were so kind and loving and caring to me, you concealed my sins not only from friend and family. Even angels appointed on me, you concealed some sins from them, giving me opportunity to come back and nobody knows. Ya Rab, forgive even those sins. That there is no bad evil deed in my book of action whatsoever. First. Second, Ya Rab, make my days and night from tonight that my spiritual sustenance is much more increased than before. The opportunities of spiritual opportunity comes to me in abundance. Ya Rab, from tonight accept my good deeds. Ya Rab, from tonight, I want my everything that I do. Sometimes I'm asleep, sometimes I'm walking, talking, eating, anything that I do. وَأَعْمَالِ What's it? كُلَّهَا وَرْدًا وَاحِدًا. It's just like as if all of them, there's a paint of servitude to God to all of them. In any position, in any however I am, it is an example of servitude to God. Make me like that. Ya Rab, make me be at your service 24/7. Not that only when I go to the masjid, not only when I'm on my prayer mat. Be at your service 24/7. I'm on duty 24/7 before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya Rab, give me a strong body to be able to worship you. Fast more, pray more. Give me strong willpower to have that willpower and the desire to be able to like motivate my body and move my body to worship you. And the Imam says, Ya Rab, give me shawqan ila liqa'i, yearning in meeting with you. And finally, Imam Amir al-Mu'min says, Ya Rab, my last request, subhanAllah, do you see he's asking nothing for dunya. Imam says that I'm only yearning, I'm here wailing, crying, Ya Rab, because I want jawarika ma'al mu'mineen. I want, grant me to live with you in the neighborhood of the believers, in the neighborhood of, like we would say, Ahlul Bayt, the awliya, sulaha, anbiya, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sallu ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad.